In this lesson, we will see how to allow deleting a record in the database. And we're going to do this again on the contact details screen. So we want to add a third button here to our form to delete this contact. So let me just drag and drop. And in the button label, we're going to write down delete. And now I need to bind this button to a screen action, and I'm going to use a shortcut here. I'm going to double click the delete button, and this creates the delete action. Great. And on this delete action, we will need to use another entity action. This is the delete entity action, which deletes the record. It receives as an input parameter the ID of the contact, in this case, to be deleted. So here in the data tab, delete contact, here we have it. And instead of receiving a record as the other actions that we used, this delete contact actually receives the contact ID. Okay, and once we delete this contact, again, we want to redirect the user back to the contacts page. And again here, I'm going to use another shortcut, drag and drop the contact screen on top of the end. And this creates a destination to the contacts page. Okay, we're done. We just need to do something here because this delete action, it doesn't make much sense to be visible when we are creating a new contact. So again, we're going to use the same condition we used for the UI if. So let me just copy paste this to make it quicker. Control C. And we're going to use this condition in a property of the button, which is the visible property. This is again an expression that returns true or false. And when it is true, the button is visible, the button is rendered in the page. When it is false, it is not rendered. So if this expression is set with, let me just use Control V here, with contact ID equal to null identifier, this means that, well, actually this is not the condition that we want, because I only want the button to be visible when I have the contact ID filled in. So actually, instead of using the equal here, I'm going to use the not equal, the different operator. So when my contact ID is different from null, when it's not creating a new contact, then show the delete button. Okay, we're done. Let's test this in the browser. Okay, let's try to delete here a contact. Let's say that we want to delete, well, let's delete John Doe that we created in the previous lesson. And delete. And we no longer have John Doe. So it seems to be working. Let me just try to do this again and go over the page lifecycle so that we're sure that we know what's going on. Let me just open here Maria. What happens when we press this delete button is that, again, a request is made to the server. The delete screen action gets executed. And on this delete screen action, we are using the delete entity action, which in turn is going to the database. It is finding Maria's contact here, and it is deleting it from the database. And once this screen action ends, we are actually using that destination, so we are actually redirecting to the contacts page. And again, the preparation is executed, and on that preparation we are again fetching the contacts from the database, and then those contacts that are returned are rendered one by one during the server-side render stage. And then this is sent back, the response is sent back to be shown here in the browser. And when this response is sent back to the browser, we will no longer find Maria Horn on our contact list. That's it.